Andrew, it's my understanding that I was suspended because of the felonies, and I respect that. But it's my understanding that the superintendent recommended the no pay. I believe that's a conflict of interest because the no pay and why I was here is because of following the directions of the superintendent, the assistant superintendent, and the school board attorney. Approximately a year ago, I felt that investigations were not being conducted fairly. When investigations are not conducted fairly, we enter into potential lawsuits.
Excuse me, I would object to this.
That's different. I've left that alone. What's different?
I object to this because it's irrelevant. I mean, how lawsuits have been handled.
If the superintendent's asking for no pay and she's responsible for me being here, how is that irrelevant?
The issue is whether or not the board had the authority to suspend Mr. Farley without pay as a result of four felony arrests. That is the issue. These other matters are irrelevant. If we were here at a hearing on the termination of Mr. Farley, they would certainly be relevant and part of the testimony. But as far as the determination of whether or not the board had the authority to suspend him without pay for the four felony arrests, it is irrelevant and immaterial.
Well, my understanding of state law, which you said to me, you convinced him that I should not come to the first hearing, called him about this hearing. He wore me out last night, said I should not be here. But I've come to the point where silence is betrayal, and that's why I'm here. But I respect the board and your decision, but it's coming into focus now what's going on.
So, with the motion on the floor and the second, and the discussion, I'll conclude the discussion. Please raise your hand if you're voting in favor of the motion. Those opposed? The vote is 4-1.